Well, we've all talked about this COVID-19 relief bill, a grand total $900 billion. Many are asking how it's going to help them personally. So we're going to break some of that down. Let's first start with these direct deposits that everyone's been talking about. It won't be $1,200 like the previous COVID-19 bill. This one now only $600 to individuals who meet the criteria. It's up to $2,400 per family. When will you see the check, though? Well, that's not entirely clear right now. On Monday, Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin says, though, some checks could be in your mailbox as early as next week. Some of these other highlights of the relief package, $325 billion going towards small business relief. The package also extends the federal unemployment insurance to $300 per week through March. $25 billion also going towards rental assistance and the important one-month extension of eviction moratoriums. That was a concern as the moratorium was coming up on its end of the at the end of the year. $82 billion also going towards education and $10 billion for childcare. $29 billion for vaccine development, something Senator Young says was the light at the end of the tunnel. You hear from him in a little bit. $22 billion for testing, and then something Senator Young also specifically asked for in Indiana is the extension to expend funds from the CARES Act. To Senator Young, he says the bill is already months behind what it should have been out, and the $600 amount, well, that's a result of compromise.
The number was just the right number in order to get a bill passed. Hoosier sent me to Washington in order to get an outcome. An outcome oftentimes involves principled compromise. Hoosiers couldn't wait any longer. So much of the assistance that we did provide in this package will make its way down to the local level. So the flexibilities we offer with respect to the coronavirus relief fund will assist our municipalities in a significant way. The testing funding, and multiple additional provisions.